Hello, everyone. So, it's been yet another long while since I made a video. And I'm actually here with my new boy here. My BBB Apollo came in. And unfortunately, I was not able to do a box opening due to the saga that was getting him. He was sent out on Saturday, but the tracking number never worked, so I couldn't figure out, you know, when he was arriving. So I came home Wednesday to a note on my door, you know, misslip. And it said I could sign the back to have him left there, but I didn't have the, apparently when I checked, I wasn't able actually to pick him up. And I was afraid to leave him because when I left for work Thursday, I went outside and there was some guy with a bike, like drinking a beer, and saying he was getting the day started. And I was about to leave the slip, I really was, but then I was like, oh my God, what is it? I don't want this guy being like, oh, what's this in this package? And of course, I don't know what time they deliver. I didn't know if the guy would still be there or if some other person would be down there. I don't know. Like, I just got really super nervous. So I decided to give them a call. The only other option I had, because I could not call off work, was to have them delivered to work. When I call FedEx, they won't let you do that. It has to be the person who shipped it who has to change the address, but they let me. And so I did, and had him delivered to work. But apparently, since he's from China, because I ordered from BBB directly, my job thought he was a bomb. So, not only was he, like, held up there at work, apparently, mind you, because the VP of my area had to tell me what was going on, because they had to call her down there, apparently. Not only that, they had to scan him a whole bunch of times. The delivery person had to print out proof of every step his package took and all this blah blah blah. It was so epic that I actually, when I got him at work, I opened him because I was afraid that, like, with all the testing and stuff they had to do to make sure he was not a bomb, that they had, that something may have happened to him. So I was really worried and just went ahead and opened him there, which was also intriguing because, of course, my coworkers were there and they know I collect these dolls, but they've never seen any of my dolls. I've put dolls as my computer background before, but they've never seen any of my dolls and they've never seen one in person except my friend Leslie has seen my little, my tiny Cecile. Sorry. And, so I opened this, him at work, you know, doll 60, 1 centimeters of him, cause he's on the gang body, not the, original BBB Apollo body. And he was naked and had no hair. He came with these eyes, which I have not removed or done anything with yet. But yeah, so I had to open a big old naked doll at work, and it was partly funny, partly like, oh my God, this is kind of embarrassing. But yeah, so I opened him at work, so there's no formal box opening. He's just here now. And I actually restrung him last night. I will say this. Don't ever restrain when you're exhausted, because the reason why I haven't been making videos or doing actually much in the hobby recently is because I've been exhausted trying to do a new schedule for myself, and because I have been working late, and just basically I'm just behind on everything and tired, and it's just but I wanted to get him dressed, but I didn't want him all floppy, which he was. He was, like, his arms were kicky, which I thought was funny. His arms were kicky, but the rest of his body would just be a flop. Like, you could just hold it, his torso in your hand, and he'd just flop over. So I wanted to tighten up his strings, and basically restring him so his string is in his head. I didn't just want to tighten it, which I could have done. But also, I wanted to take him apart to really hot glue suede him. So I did that, and the hot glue sweating actually went pretty well. Oh, cool. did do that. The hot glue sweating actually went pretty well. But when I went to put him back together, first of all, I put his arms on the wrong way. It's funny, I got this arm on, and I noticed that his elbow was facing the front, and I was like, that doesn't seem right. So I actually had to go to look at the body online to see what the heck was wrong. So I did that, and I switched arms. I'm glad I did before, like, I got any further in the process. And then I did his legs, which were the most horrible thing ever, because I was so tired. It was getting really late, and it had taken me forever with the suiting, and it took me forever with the arms, because I like to get them as even in tension as I can. And the string he has in him, I just reused it, even though I don't know if it's exactly SD size, but since he's light, I decided it probably would work. And plus the S hook in his feet, the top part that attaches to the string can just barely go on it. So, like, I was like, maybe I shouldn't put thicker elastic in him, and maybe the hot glue weight would be enough. So I'm trying to put the legs on. First of all, I had to restring this leg like 3 times, and then I get to the foot, and I can't for the life of me get the foot on. It's to a point where I'm just like, my hands are getting tired, I'm tired, and I'm pulling out the string again to try to put his foot back on, but since my fingers are sore and I'm tired, I accidentally let go, it flips back, and the S hook goes into my finger. And I'm just out there crying and screaming because it's like, oh my god. And like, I was in so much shock about the whole thing that like, it was painful more afterwards than during it. I managed to finally pull it back out. I was lucky to have some ribbon right beside me that I could use. I pulled it out. It took a second though. And I was just like, I was walking around and crying for just like a half hour. It was horrible. But then I went back to it because I couldn't let it go. Like, I didn't want to leave him unstrung for the night. And I did want to get him dressed and get him as complete as possible. And I felt bad for him. So, I went back at it, and it took me an hour. I strung both legs and had, like, glue sticks in the elastic at the feet so I can figure out how to freaking get the S hook on. It took an hour for me to realize a way to do it, and it actually turned out to be really simple, and I feel really stupid about it now. I actually was surprised I figured it out. I was so mad. But I figured it out. He has his feet, dumbass, and I got to sleep at 12:30, so I'm really tired. but he's together, he's hot glue suited, he can stand very well, but the gang body is weird. I'm not sure how to explain it. Maybe I'm not, like, he has a joint here that's just really awkward, and I'm not sure if I'm doing it right, so it's going to take me a second to get used to him. But I'm glad to have him home, and it's funny, seeing him in person, I'm starting to understand why, like, what my problem was all this time with this particular mold. Like, I think he's friggin' adorable, but now I see what maybe my apprehension was about him. It's just that his features are, like, really big on his face, and his face is really wide. But he's so friggin' adorable that, like, I don't know. And plus, he fits Sparrow so well that, like, you know, even though he's not, like, a sculpt that was really at the top of my list, I'm glad to have him home. So, and, you know, plus I'm angry at him. So, he's home. Sparrow's home. The leader of my band. And I have to write out more of his backstory, so I'll probably introduce him, like, officially in a later video when he has his face up and everything. And I'm not sure about his eyes. This wig is not staying. It's the only blonde wig I have, so it's been, like, transferred to, like, 3 different dolls now. It's the only blonde wig I have home until I can get his wig next week. I have to order it from Spite and Malice because they're the only one who has the color of fur I want. So yeah, so he's here. And then as for other updates, my hopefully, I got a slip saying the package had shipped. It's supposedly from Leak World, and hopefully it actually contains my Leak World Ashley. Because whenever I log into Leak's website, I don't see the order for my Ashley, just the order for the wigs. And they're saying the wigs shipped. I'm like, where's my Ashley order? I actually questioned them on it. They're like, oh no, we're getting it out as soon as possible. I'm like, that's not what I'm asking. But I'll wait and see what I get from the post office tomorrow to, you know, start bombarding them with anything. So I should be getting her tomorrow, and hopefully I'll be able to do a box opening for her. Other than that, not too much, because I am still paying off dolls. My last payment on my Dollzone order will be next week, next Friday. And they are finally there. They got there, I think, yesterday. So they'll be able to ship out as soon as I make the payment. I didn't get any news about my doll leaves order. And the doll chateau body I ordered, of course, probably will be like 2 more months at the least. Probably, I'm guessing 3 or 4. But we'll see. I put on hold a, if you've heard of, what's her actual, her company used to be, she made this Shinji head that I've talked about. It's now called Little Rebels though, and she came out with a new head that's like LR08 head that she calls Haichi, I believe. I put him on right away because I need this head. I just fell in love with it. I can't help it. So I don't know who he'll be, but I need to get him. The only other thing on the horizon is I'm going to try my best to get in on this mini-me group order for a head of Tom Hiddleston, aka Loki, because I'm obsessed with him and I want a BGD of him, and I also want the figure of him, so there's going to be hopefully a lot of Loki in my house. I adore him. It's kind of crazy, and it makes me feel like I'm 12 again, but you know, whatever. And I entered a challenge for sewing. It's on DOA. And if anyone else has seen it and is joining, we should motivate each other. It's just basically, you know, you pick a doll, and then in the second week, which is what the project is in now, you just pick out your materials, and then the third week, you actually sew the outfit. And I put my doll sister Olivia in because she's the only one who actually really needs clothes, and she's the only one that, like, I can't really buy clothes for. So I entered her, and I'll probably keep updated on that because I'm loving her look. I'd show you, but her look is not complete now. I plan to sew her some stuff tomorrow. And let's see. Okay, I think that's actually it. Yeah, I didn't have many updates, and the reason why I'm doing the video is mostly because of him, and I felt really bad not doing a box opening because I've been waiting for him, and I just love him. And yeah, I'll introduce him more once his face up is done and everything, and hopefully you'll like him. So that is all. I will see you in my next video, which I hope is the box opening of Leak World, actually. So that's all for now. Thank you. Bye.